1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Jim Condep here, and welcome to A Very Keen Christmas. You're probably wondering, what is A Very Keen Christmas? Well, normally around this time of the year, churches will gather, particularly for Christmas Eve services, and bring their congregations together. But this year, we can't do that. So two churches that are deeply invested in the Greater Keene community, Elm City Church and Monadnock Covenant, have come together to bring you A Very Keen Christmas. A night of great music, a night of some fun kid videos, and a message of hope. And also an opportunity for you to give back to an organization in our community, Monadnock Family Services, that has done so much for so many. So sit back, relax, and thanks so much for being with us tonight.
The first, no. Too certain for shepherds in fields and they lay in camp where they keep their sheep on a cold winter's night.
Nowhere, nowhere,
look tough and saw the sun shining in the east beyond and far and the earth.
Until the sky is open, until the strong
An important part of A Very Keen Christmas is giving back to our community. And this year we've chosen to partner with Monadnock Family Services, an organization that does so much for so many in the greater community here of Keene. We would ask you to consider a donation, a generous donation to this organization that does so much for so many. And all donations received tonight will be matched by a generous donor. There's a link on your screen where you can donate right now. And here's a short video so you can learn more about Monadnock Family Services.
We make a huge difference in Keene as MFS, from housing to making sure people have enough food to eat, to helping them deal with natural stressors and infrequent stressors. I think we really change the lives of people who live in Keene, and I think we do a good job at showing other communities what it's like to be part of a mental health center.
MFS means to me community and hope in the community.
I think the impact that MFS has is a good impact. It's we're here for the people that in a lot of cases are forgotten about, and we're here to help them and make it so they're not forgotten and that they're part of the active community. I work with all the local agencies. I work with Southwestern, the city, Hunter Knights, the fire department, the police department. I work with all the different departments here in Keene, and we work hand in hand. It's not just about me, it's about the bigger picture, and we like to serve everybody across the board.
People who come and come to work for Monadnock Family Services are interested and curious about working with people during their times of great need. I'm looking for compassionate, committed, and dedicated workers to come and be a part of our team.
If someone is thinking about making an impact on someone's life daily, they should definitely consider MFS, as that's what we do. We're everyday superheroes.
Monadnock Family Services has been inspiring hope.
Inspiring hope.
Inspiring hope since 1905.
The community in Keene, beautiful place. Greetings from the West Coast. This is Propaganda. Just want to share a little encouragement with you in this season. I know this has been probably one of the most bizarre years any of us have had in a long time, you know, and in a time where we're trying to find hope because, you know, the year is supposed to change, you know, maybe some of your situations don't, or you're looking at a future that's kind of hard to be hopeful about. Maybe you find yourself bitter over this year, or cynical. I find myself kind of bouncing between both. But at the same time, hopeful. And I don't want to shame you for any of your feelings, but I do have this poem I kind of been working on all year that kind of like puts both of those ideas together. It's called The Cynical Imagine, because I know sometimes it's kind of hard to imagine things being any better. Bitterness keeps our eyes in the back of our head, our ears to the past, our feet in starting blocks in lieu of trigger, remembering all the moments that destroyed the sense of self. that mangles the taste of leftover joy, the bitter remember, the cynical, quite different. The cynical can taste the winds of change. The cynical can smell the future. What of its fragrance is foul and is flowersome? The cynical can smell the future. Sage or wormwood, better or worse, they can see what might be and what we should do. They visualize what could be yet can't. At a guttural moaning level, understand why no one else can see it. The cynical can imagine. The bitter remember. I am the cynic's imagination and the source of bitterness. I don't shame either, because in me contains a paradox. The cynical imagine. Imagine the divine incarnate. The incarnation, in the middle of all the turmoil and chaos, God becoming man. Imagine. All right, Keen, we'll see you guys soon.
Good evening. My name is Jenna Frost, and I am one of the pastors at Monadnock Covenant Church. And you know, this year I've been thinking a lot about hope. And it's almost Christmas Eve when we celebrate the single most joyous, the single most hopeful event in history, the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. We celebrate what happened on Christmas Eve all those nearly 2,000 years ago. You know, there were people there that night, and they longed for his coming. They were people of great hope, anticipating his birth. The Christmas carol, O Come, Emmanuel, speaks strongly of this longing, of this hope. As the people of Israel waited and hoped for the coming Messiah, we too wait and hope for Christ's return. Sometimes I wonder what it must have been like to be in Bethlehem that night. I wonder if people knew that something was different. I suspect many people in Bethlehem missed it. They merely went about their days as normal, waiting and longing for the day that something indeed would change. But I do have to imagine that there were some who noticed the bright star in the sky, some who felt the weight of Jesus' entrance into our humanity. While they probably didn't understand every intricate detail of God's plan, they knew that night was different. They knew that night was special, and they knew that night was holy. In a year when hope has been hard to find, we trust in the good news of the coming Christ, in the good news of Jesus' birth. And we are more hopeful than ever that better days are ahead for all of us. So tonight, we cling to hope.
And ransom care.
unto thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Oh, 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 oh. He's come, he's come.
Christmas is coming down on Christmas morning with my sister and seeing all of the lights and the presents in the living room, and it makes me really happy. Merry Christmas!
Santa brought us our presents.
When Santa brought us our presents.
And?
Jesus!
When you get to open up the presents.
When we bake Christmas cookies.
Spending time with family and just the overall happiness that everyone has.
Celebrating the happiness and the birth of Jesus.
Having family time.
I want to get to Christmas with a car. A Christmas going to a car.
Okay. Yep.
My favorite thing about Christmas is that Jesus was born.
My favorite thing about Christmas is the candlelight service.
First, all the delicious, delicious cookies, and the other thing, seeing the joy on people's faces when they open the presents.
Jesus was born.
My favorite part of Christmas is spending time with family.
My favorite thing about Christmas is that Jesus was born and he saved us, but I also really like the presents.
My favorite part about Christmas is having time with my family.
Favorite part of Christmas is when I get to see my cousin and I love to wrap the gifts and open the gifts.
Eating appetizers, spending time with family, and we have a scavenger hunt to find our presents every year, and it's all just super fun.
Ollie, what's your favorite thing?
His favorite thing is probably the presents.
I do not know why he's not speaking.
One thing I've enjoyed doing this year with my family is driving around and looking at all the Christmas light displays. I have a 3-year-old and a 6-year-old, And this scenario has played itself out several times in the Powers household. It's 5:15. It's been dark for an hour and a half. We've already had dinner, and there's still 2 hours till bedtime. So what we do is we pile everyone in the car, and we drive around, and we look at Christmas lights displays. I live out in Spofford, and in a lot of the back roads in Spofford, there's no street lights, which allows you to see a good Christmas light display from far away. You know, as you're driving, you see the glow, and the anticipation starts to build. You kind of look in the back seat of, hey, guys, guess what? Good one is coming. Because, you know, and when it's pretty dark out, you can see a little bit of light from far away. In fact, the human eye can detect a candle under the right conditions from almost 30 miles away. And in the days before electricity lit up the dark night skies, some people who lived on country roads, what they would do, whether they're a tavern owner or just someone who was, you know, it was pretty good hospitality, they would put a candle in their window so that weary travelers, especially in the cold winter months, would know that up ahead was a place of safety, a place of warmth, a place where they can stay. You know, I can just picture someone who's cold, tired, wet, seeing that little candle flame from far away, and that just filling them with hope. Because they know that what that candle represents is more than just a little flame. What that candle represents is warmth, a meal, and a great place to stay. And that candle flame, though small, would have been to them kind of looked like a blazing symbol of hope. You know, for many of us, this has been a tough year. You know, COVID has upended so many of our plans, has disrupted our lives, and has added a ton of stress. You know, I am so sick of hearing the phrase in these unprecedented times. You know what I want right now? Precedented times. I am sick of unprecedented times. And we could all use something to give us some hope. You know, one of the big reasons why Elm City Church and Monadnock Covenant Church, why we came together for this event was one, we love this community, but two, we wanted to share some hope. But not just hope in general or just a vague hope that things are gonna get better. What we wanted to do is share with you the hope that we have in Jesus. And the story of Christmas, it can be summed up this way, that God is real, God cares, and he refuses to remain distant. Instead, God could have remained distant and detached from our struggles, but instead he chose the opposite path. And in Jesus, God came to us. John 1:14, one of my favorite translations of this passage, it says this, God became a man and moved into the neighborhood. Jesus came to show us what God is like. And the ultimate act of love, he took upon himself our sin and struggles, and he provided a way of rescue. He has on offer forgiveness, healing, and reconciliation. Christmas is about Jesus doing for us what we could not do for ourselves. You know, that traveler on the, you know, that's out in the dark on those in that cold winter night that sees that flame, he still in his own strength has to struggle towards his hope. He still has to try, he still has to make it there in his own strength to see his hope realized. But Christmas tells a different story. It's not a story of us seeing a flicker of hope far off and working our way towards it. Christmas is not a story about us discovering some light that is within and summoning something up. You know, it's the exact opposite. It's hope coming to us in a most unexpected way. In Luke chapter 2, in the Luke narrative, the one that Linus reads in answer to Charlie Brown's famous question, you know, can't anybody tell me what Christmas is all about? Linus reads Luke 2, and this is what he says. The angels say, announce to the shepherds. They say, fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which shall be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. I love that. Good news of great joy for all people. A Savior has been born. And Jesus' offer of salvation, it's a gift that's available to all that see their need for rescue, no exceptions. Now that's good news. Now, lately I've heard a few people say, you know, I was doing really good for the first part of this, but man, I don't know what's going on, but now I'm starting to struggle. So if you find yourself there, I want to encourage you in two ways tonight. One, God often uses seasons of darkness and difficulty to reveal our need for him. And secondly, God often shines brightest in our life when all seems dark around us. I know personally some of the times I felt closest to God were when my circumstances and situations were the most
difficult. You know, maybe that's where you're at. Remember, there's a God. He cares, and he refuses to remain distant. And because of that, we can have hope, no matter what our circumstances may be. Now, if all this is new to you and you're curious, you know, this is something about tonight has sparked something in you, I would encourage you, reach out, because both of our communities, both of our faith communities would love to help you explore the way of Jesus. Maybe you know, haven't been a part of a church for a while, and this whole season has made you curious about wanting to come back. Again, reach out. We would love to help you take your next step in your faith journey. But I want to end tonight with a challenge for all of us. You know, in this season of Christmas, in this season where so much has been uncertain, turned upside down, maybe even scary for you, here is my challenge. How can you be a person whose life displays this hope? What can you do to make a difference in the lives of the people around you? And it doesn't have to be big. It could be something small, something you do for your family, a friend, neighbor, a coworker. What can you do to display hope? One real practical thing you can do tonight before the night is over is you can make a gift to Monadnock Family Services. Like I said, we have someone who has generously said whatever comes in, they're going to match it. So I think what we should do is make that offer very uncomfortable for them. That's something we can all do to give back to a great organization that is providing tangible hope to people in our community. And as a follower of Jesus, this is what I want to end with. This is what I believe with all of my heart. Hope confidently looks forward to a better future, not based on our circumstances, but based on the faithfulness of God. God exists. He cares, and he refuses to remain distant. You know, if God can humble himself and come in the form of a baby, if he modeled that much humility, we can do it likewise. So in this season, let's choose hope. Merry Christmas.
Oh, Sun.